Good morning, everybody. Adam Josh here. Are you getting sick of this yet? Anybody else? What do we see here? 1, 2, 3 fanning out into this cloud formation. I'm gonna go with, that's a 4th, 5th, and there's some sideways 6th thing here going over here. And over here you can see real clouds. Those of you too young to remember, that's what real clouds look like. The fluffy things that these, Nazi pilots, can't seem to figure out how to duplicate. And now, surprise, we have this cloud bank coming, and it's been raining here for 2 days, and when it hasn't been raining, guess what you've been able to see in the sky? Lots and lots of chemtrails. But it's a contrail, Adam. Alright, you're stupid. You don't know what a contrail is. A contrail is condensation. Does that look like condensation to you? Condensation evaporates. A few inches, if you're looking at it from our angle, a few inches behind the plane. Does this look like it's evaporated a few inches behind the plane? No. Oh, it's just planes dumping their excess fuel along their flight path. Does that look like a flight path to you? And if they're dumping fuel, has anybody told them not to pollute over the city? They're not dumping fuel. Let's not be childish in our understanding here. I'm sort of coming to the conclusion that either they think they're protecting us from Russian-type energy, directed energy weapons. Look up, if you're on the internet right now, Google direct energy weapons Russia, or if you're on my website, go to the special guest section where it says no power, and then read the article that Fiona wrote. And watch the 45-minute video there, because pretty powerful information. And there may be some aluminum, barium, and heavy metals in these chemtrails that they're shielding, using as a shield from direct energy weapons. I mean, we're not in 1920s anymore, you know? Like, this is the future. We're living in the future. We don't need to be on fossil fuels anymore, you know. We had the electric car, you know, years ago, decades ago. Pardon me. Absolute nonsense. Absolutely obnoxious and ridiculous, and I'm beyond fed up. I'm beyond angry. I don't even know what to do anymore. This is what I'm doing. I'm standing on the roof and filming the sky and ranting into a camera and hoping that somebody else out there takes action with me. I mean, I've emailed people, I've talked to people, I tell my friends, can we sue the government for doing this? The pilots gotta think they're doing something good. I mean, the pilot's got to be fed a load of BS or something, like, yeah, in the short term, you're doing some good. So we've stood here and watched this one sort of fan out even more into this thing over here. I mean, that's not a cloud. You understand that, right? That's not a natural cloud. When people look up at the sky and their entire sky is made of haze like this, you gotta understand that this is a man-made chemical cloud that's coming down on you. And then coincidentally, as I said, it rained the last 2 days here pretty heavily. And I usually don't get headaches, but this last 2 days I've had headaches. And it might be subconscious by now, and it might be just whatever's in these chemtrails giving me a headache. I don't know if it's so diabolic that Monsanto is making aluminum or barium resistant seeds and they think that you're gonna have to buy their engineered seeds. I don't know if it's that diabolical. I don't know if it's diabolical as they think they're protecting us from Russian weapons. I don't know if it's simple weather manipulation or modification. But what I do know is that these aren't contrails. It's not gas being dumped in the sky. The EPA and federal regulations and provincial regulations and, I mean, everything would prevent that from happening if they're just dumping gas or oil in the sky. Like I said, let's not be childish in our understanding. This is a little bit more sinister than gas being dumped in the sky. And if gas is being dumped in the sky, would you think it would be dumped over major city centers specifically? I mean, you can see, as I've pointed out in other videos, where the plane will be going, it'll stop chemtrailing and keep going, start again, you know, over major city centers. So this is strategic chemtrailing, and don't think any differently. And as I said 1,000 times, I don't even know what to say anymore. Here we go. A really good example of normal clouds. Look at that. Normal cloud formation coming over here and coincidentally holding it off at the banks is these chemtrails. Chemtrails, 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 chemtrails. And look, natural clouds, natural clouds, natural clouds, natural clouds, natural clouds. Is it a coincidence? I don't know. I think I might start wearing a gas mask every day. This is your future. This is what's annoying, is that the people who are chemtrailing, maybe they don't live here, maybe they don't live in major city centers, but this is your future, you know? You're ruining your own future. So don't think that you have any future if you don't do anything about this. You can't ignore this. I mean, you can, sure, you can ignore a lot of things. Do whatever you want to do. I'm just saying, look at this. This is ridiculous. Obnoxiously ridiculous. Like, I don't even know, what is that? Is there people? Look at this. What is this? Yeah, that's just what clouds look like. Is that what people tell their kids nowadays? Yeah, that's just what clouds look like. When I was younger, we knew what a clear sky looked like. We could see the stars at night. And during the day, we could actually see. This is so annoying. Look at this. Yeah, that's just what clouds look like. What, you know? When you were younger, didn't clouds look like straight lines? I don't know what else to say. I said that, I don't know. It's 8 o'clock in the morning, and I don't want to rant anymore into a camera. But I'm upset, and I'm legitimately upset. Nobody's paying me to do this. I'm actually doing this on my own accord, and I'm just irritated. And I wish I could stop them. I wish I could fix it. I wish I could go up there and tell the pilots to stop. I wish I could land the plane somehow without injuring anybody or hurting anybody. I don't know. I just want it to stop. And I want to know why they're doing it.